Okay, so this video is going to cover simplifying radicals, but specifically with examples that have variables thrown in there. Okay, so there's two little rules that we need to remember when it comes to simplifying radicals that have variables. And one for if we have an even power, and then the other rule is for when it is odd. So let's start with the even power, since that's the example that we're looking at here. When taking a square root of a term that has an even-powered exponent, we divide that exponent by 2. So we cut it in half. So by taking the square root, all we're doing is dividing that power in half. So then to take the square root of this example, since we have a 6 as our exponent, and 6 divided by 2 is 3, we would get x to the third power. That wasn't that bad, right? So let's move on to another example here. So here we have one that has a number and a variable part of the radicand. If you didn't know, the radicand is just the fancy way of saying what's underneath that radical symbol. So taking the square root here, so we would need to consider that a number is not the same thing as a variable, so the rule is just slightly different. So we should also remember the product rule. Now, the product rule tells us that we can split up our factor here. So since we have 36m to the eighth, or 36 times m to the eighth, the product rule says we can split that up to the square root of 36 times the square root of m to the eighth. And we can simplify each one of these. Taking a look at our number, the square root of 36, that just happens to be a perfect square. So square root of 36 is 6. Square root of m to the eighth. So when dealing with variables and it's an even power, just chop it in half. So 8 divided by 2 is 4. So the square root of m to the eighth is m to the fourth, giving us our final answer here of a 6m to the fourth. Our next example, the square root of 408 to the sixth. So again, we're dealing with a number and a variable part of our problem here. So let's go ahead and use the product rule to split that apart. We have the square root of 400 times the square root of a to the sixth. So let's take a look at our number first. Here we have the square root of 400. Now, the list that I typically use just has the first 12 perfect squares. If we were to continue on that list and get to 20, that would help us out a little bit better here. Or better yet, when trying to take the square root of numbers, it would probably be a good idea to go ahead and plug it into the calculator to see if it happens to be a perfect square. If we have a little problems maybe remembering, you know, which ones are and which ones aren't. Now, if we plug and check this into the calculator, the square root of 400 happens to be 20. Okay, moving on to our variable, the square root of a to the sixth. Here we have an even number, and when it comes to even numbers, we divide it by 2. So 6 divided by 2 gives us a 3, so the square root of a to the sixth is a cubed, giving us our final answer here of 20a to the third. Our next example is the square root of x to the seventh. So here we're dealing with an odd numbered exponent. So the rule for taking the square root of an odd numbered exponent says this. It says to factor out a power of 1. Okay, so what is that talking about? So taking a look at the exponent x to the seventh, hopefully we do know that that is just x times x times x times x times x times x times x, right? We have 7 of them. And each of these are raised to the first power, right? So x to the seventh is just a representation of all of these. We would add these exponents up to get the 7. So if I want to take out just one of them, so I kind of want to split one off. And if I did that, using the product rule, right? The product rule says that we can factor what we have here. So if I pulled out one of them, so I'm talking about just pulling out x to the first, just one of them, what would I be left with if I pulled that out? Well, I'd be left with 6 of them, right? So I'm going to take x to the seventh and factor that out to x to the first times x to the sixth. Right, had this been x to the ninth, I would have pulled one out and I would have been left with an x to the eighth, right? Or if I would have had x to the 13th, that would have factored to an x to an x to the 12th. So you're just pulling out one. Okay, so after we've pulled out that factor, will it simplify, right? So we need to go ahead and take the square root of what we can. Now, what we can take the square root of is the x to the 6. We can take the square root of an even powered term here. So we have x to the 6. To take the square root of that, we divide that by 2. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. So we would get an x to the 3rd whenever we take the square root of that. Now this x sitting over here, square root of x, that has a power of 1. We can't chop that in half. We don't want a half power. We don't want a decimal. So that would actually kind of just be considered, we can't simplify it, so we just drop it down. So we're going to drop down the square root of the x. So we took the square root of the even powered one, and we just dropped down that extra one kind of hanging out there. So our final solution here would be x cubed times the square root of x. Okay, so for this particular example, we have the square root of 100 c to the 4th d cubed. So the first thing that I'm going to do here, since we have a lot of things going on, I'm going to go ahead and use the product rule to split this apart. I'm going to split apart our number, so I'm going to take the square root of 100 times the square root of the c to the 4th times the square root of d cubed. And remember, the product rule tells us that we can do this. And then I'm just going to take a look at each one of these and try and break them down individually, starting with the square root of 100. Well, square root of 100, that happens to be a perfect square. Square root of 100 is 10. Moving on to the next one, we have the square root of c to the 4th. That's an even power, so all we have to do is divide that by 2. So 4 divided by 2 is 2, so we're left with c squared. The last one that we have there is the square root of d to the 3rd power. So when we have an odd powered here, we got to pull one of them out. So when we have an odd number as our exponent, we need to factor out a power of 1. So that's going to look like we're going to take out one of the d's. And if I take out 1 from here, right, 3 minus 1 is going to leave me with 2 of them. All right, we need to remember the product rule for exponents that says that when we multiply, we add exponents. 1 plus 2 is this 3 that we had, so we can split it up that way. Now, we're not quite done yet. We have this radical over here that we can simplify. We can take the square root of d squared because that's an even power. So before doing that, let me drop down what I have here in front. So we had the 10. We had the c squared. Let's go ahead and take the square root of this d here. Square root of d squared, all we got to do is divide that by 2, right? 2 divided by 2 is 1. So we're left with d to the 1st. And then all that's left to do is to drop down that square root of a d. It's to the 1st power. We can't chop that in half, so we just drop it down. Also remember, when it comes to stating your answer, when it comes to these here, numbers typically go in first, followed by your variables, typically in order of the alphabet, right? C comes before D. And then radicals, we almost kind of treat those as our variable when thinking about a regular expression here. They're tacked on to the end. So 10 C squared D times the square root of D would be our solution for this.